In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Space Replicator, a powerful plugin that lets you experience virtual acoustic spaces on your headphones for mixing and for mixed translation checks. I'm going to walk you through the various spaces and the unique features of this plugin. So in order to get started, you're going to place an instance of the plugin on your master stereo bus in your DAW. Make sure it's the very last plugin in your plugin chain. Open the plugin and select your headphones from the drop-down menu of over 600 popular headphone models. This will apply a calibration profile to your headphones to ensure that you have the most accurate listening experience possible. Next, select your binaural profile from the drop-down menu. If you haven't created one yet, click on New Binaural Profile, and you'll be taken to an online test where you can follow the prompts to create one. Simply follow the prompts, select your headphones again from the drop-down list, and you're going to audition different sound samples and choose ones which have the most realistic sounding stereo image, as if you're sitting in a room listening to the speakers. Once you finish the test, you can name your profile. Now head back to the plugin and click the sync button. Your new custom binaural profile should show up in the drop-down list. Now that you've selected your profile, you can start listening. If you're listening to material that's been mastered or is peaking close to 0 dB, you'll definitely want to engage safe headroom to ensure you don't hear any distortion from clipping. You can also manually dial in the amount of headroom you need with the volume knob if you want to maximize the amount of output gain you have available. Space Replicator comes with a great variety of world-class studio environments. Each space has a unique character and a different specialized purpose. We recommend picking the studio you like best and spending some time getting used to it. Develop familiarity with its unique characteristics, just as you would in a real room. And then you'll have a studio that you can bring anywhere and make accurate mix decisions. The first studio is LEWITT Studio A. This is the main studio of the LEWITT headquarters, and it's perfect for mixing and critical listening. It features a custom-made speaker system by David Heigner. Next up, you can mix in Vienna's Synchron Stage. This is a world-class orchestra and film scoring studio where many of the scores from your favorite movies were made. In Control A, you get the choice of monitoring through far-field speakers or mid-field speakers. The far-field speakers are great for mixing orchestras, where you need some space to hear how all the elements of the orchestra are placed in the stereo field. The next studio environment we have is White Sea Studio, featuring the Lenart Quasar system. This is a precisely tuned room with a short decay that's great for mastering, editing, or mixing. The speakers are tuned with a tamed high-end to avoid ear fatigue during long mixing sessions. And for LEWITT Studio B, we have a minimalistic and precise studio with near-field speakers and a carefully tuned sub. This is ideal for checking and refining your mixes thanks to the acoustically transparent desk that reduces early reflections. In Control B, you have powerful speakers in a mid-size room, providing a nice balanced option for any mixing or critical listening task. Beyond studios, we also have a set of spaces to ensure your mixes translate well. These are spaces where you're likely to encounter music in real life, so they're a great way to see how things will sound to the listener. First up is the classic car test. A lot of us listen to music in our car more than just about anywhere else, so this is a great place to get a new perspective on your mix and see if the vocal is sitting at the right level or if the low end is balanced properly. And not to be outdone when it comes to realism, we even allow you to listen from different perspectives in the car, including the driver's seat, passenger front seat, the back seat left, and the back seat right. Then we have the Watergate Club. This is an iconic nightclub that's a great place to check tracks if you're an electronic music or hip-hop producer. The main floor is a great place to put your music to the hardest test. If your low end sounds clean and well-defined there, it's definitely ready for release. The main floor with a crowd delivers a warmer and more focused sound where you can check the potential of your track in a packed club. And finally, the DJ booth offers you a different perspective with ceiling-mounted monitors that can give you a little bit more definition in the high end. And like with the main floor, you can listen to how it sounds empty or in a packed club. In the living room space, you can listen to how your mix sounds playing through a device like a smartphone held in front of you. You can choose from a variety of phone and laptop models that give you a more limited frequency range that can be really helpful for determining if the overall balance of your mix is working. If all the important elements of your mix still sound great through a phone or laptop speaker, then you know your song is release ready. Next, we have a kitchen with a variety of consumer listening devices like popular Bluetooth speakers and a tablet. These provide a realistic representation of how a lot of people might casually listen to your music. And then we have a TV room where you can listen to mixes through the built-in speakers. In my opinion, this is probably the worst case scenario. Not exactly the most enjoyable sound, but a great test for translation in the mid-range frequencies. There is also a soundbar system, which provides a little bit more of a high fidelity sound. In addition to virtual acoustic spaces, we've also provided popular consumer headphone models for referencing. These include HMax, H700, HXMS, HPods Pro, HBuds 2 Pro, and a transparent setting, which gives you the neutral version of your headphones with only the calibration profile applied. On this third tab, we have a news section where you can find information about updates and a link where you can provide feedback. For all the spaces, we have a couple filtering options that make navigating the plugin a little bit easier. You can choose spaces by categories like favorites, which can be designated by clicking the star icon on any space right in the upper right-hand corner, by studios, consumer devices, live venues, and other. These will become even more helpful as we continue to grow our spaces library. You can also choose to sort spaces alphabetically by name or by type. Some other features you'll want to know are in the top right corner, we have a bypass button, so you can toggle on and off without latency compensation issues and without a jump in volume. This button keeps your levels the same as you switch Space Replicator on or off. And you also have a settings menu. In the settings, you can find new updates and you can toggle a few options, including tooltips. This gives you additional information about every control you hover over with your cursor. You also have auto bypass on render. This is super helpful so you don't accidentally bounce your track with the room simulation on it. However, there might be instances when your DAW doesn't communicate that it's rendering to the plugin, so I'd always recommend double checking your mix before sending it to a client. And then you have re-trigger onboarding if you want to go back to the original welcome screen. And lastly, you can file a bug report if you encounter any odd behavior in the plugin. Thanks for watching. Let us know if you have any questions down in the comments, and I hope you have a great time making mixes you can trust with Space Replicator.